So when Fabian said, would you be interested in documenting that first voyage? I did say to her, every documentary really has got to be warts and all. You've got, everything's got to be shown. And are you happy about that? And she really was. She was incredibly open. I actually met Fabian Dattner, who was the woman behind the whole idea of Homeward Bound and that voyage. And she told me that she'd had this dream to take 76 female scientists on a ship to the Antarctic.
I was really attracted to the story because I'd made a lot of science documentaries before, and I had always noticed that there are a lot more male scientific experts around to consult and to do research with than there were female. And I really want to look at the story beneath those statistics.
When you look at women in STEM, women are in low-level positions in research institutions, and of course, the numbers just dwindle when you get to professorial level.
So when we got on the ship, I had never met any of the 76 women prior to the beginning of the journey. So I didn't know who our kind of characters were going to be. I was also looking at where does this woman's individual story fit in with some of those bigger, wider systemic obstacles. And I tried to kind of marry those. So essentially, we were on the ship kind of overwhelmed with stories.
The Antarctic was a really great backdrop for the film, and it was Fabian's idea. She'd always wanted to go there because in a way it's like the canary in the mine, and it speaks to what we could lose.
So in 27 seasons, there's been a recede of 30 feet a year. 30 feet a year. These changes are real and they're happening right here, and we're witnessing this.
I think that the film becomes more relevant every day at the moment. We've got a climate emergency and we've got a pandemic. And both of those things really elevate the importance of scientists. And of course, we need to embrace the full spectrum of human potential to put those brains on those problems.